What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you the best settings for Ni No Kuni Crossworlds on your iOS or Android device. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. I will set these settings for low to mid-end devices, which may struggle when playing the game at the default settings. Feel free to increase these settings if you feel like you have more performance to spare. Open up Ni No Kuni Crossworlds and navigate to your graphics options. First off, you can choose a graphics preset as your quick settings. This will change your overall graphics settings for the game. Lower end or older devices should choose low or normal. I'm using an iPhone 11 Pro Max, so I will set this to high. Below, make sure to enable your advanced settings. These allow you to have more control over your quality settings to tailor the game's options to your device performance. Set the texture quality to normal. I prefer to set the shadow quality option to low, as these don't break the immersion by too much for me and they are known to drain your performance. The object quality sets the structural quality of plants and natural objects. Set this option to normal or high. The detail quality will allow you to display more details at further distances, but it will decrease your performance by a lot when setting it too high. In my case, I'd suggest setting it to normal. Below, set the effect quality to normal or high, as well as your post-processing levels. The background view distance will set the vision range of your background while in-game. Set this to normal. You should set the object view distance option to a range that will not affect your performance by a lot. Most devices should be able to run mid-range fine if the options above are not too high. When using high or very high object quality, then you should consider lowering your object view distance option to mid-range and not long range. Disable anti-aliasing. Set your ambient occlusion to none and enable or disable character outlines. This will come down to your personal preference. Enabling this option might reduce your performance by a bit. In your graphics quality settings, set the frame rate to 30. For high refresh rate devices with a lot of performance, you will want to use 40 or 50 to get a smoother viewing experience. Reducing your overall render resolution can drastically improve your performance and fix lag, but it will reduce your visual quality by a lot. If you still experience lag after applying all of the next settings, then consider reducing this option to 80% or 90%. Under Performance, make sure to enable the Auto Graphics Settings During Overheating option. This will automatically adjust your graphics settings to manage temperature when your device overheats. For the number of name tags to display, make sure to set this option to your preference. The lower the amount, the higher your performance might get, but this can have no impact on your performance depending on your bottleneck. In your large battle optimization settings, you have the option to reduce the stress on your device by simplifying the appearances and costumes of characters, effects of all entities and name tags in order to prevent your device from lagging and keeping a steady frame rate. Make sure to enable all of these options. Lastly, you can enable or disable the Tap Effects option. This will have little to no impact on the performance of the game, so set this to your personal preference. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.